You've probably already seen these guys floating around on the internet. Both Matthias and Ronald Walters have excellent tutorials on how you can make these on the bandsaw. I really think the concept of multi-dimensional wooden art is interesting, so I decided to try my hand at making one. In this video, I'm going to show you how I made this wooden angel. No better place to start than at the drawing board. After searching the internet, I couldn't find any images of angels that I figured were satisfactory for what I'm making, so I started by sketching out half of what I thought an angel should look like, and then I used the tracing table to produce the other side. Sorry about the interference pattern, but you get the idea how I did it. After the drawing was completed, I scanned it and used photo editing software to break it into two halves. Next, I printed out a template, which I'll make available to you by a link in the description. Now I've just used spray adhesive to affix the patterns to these blocks of wood. The bulk of this project is done on the bandsaw, and if you've ever done anything like this before, then you probably realize that if I just jump right in and start making this cut, I'm going to cut my pattern off. Because of this problem, this is kind of a tedious project, and it's kind of clumsy the way that I'm going to do it. I'm going to have to make each of my cuts in a specific order. The best way to solve any problem is to start by doing what you know you can do first. Now we can take this pattern off temporarily for the next part. Hopefully you didn't use too much spray adhesive. The hardest part of this project is definitely over. Now you can see that I put the pattern back on and there's a slight distortion because it's bending around a curve. I'm just going to use a little bit of judgment to blend this cut along so that it looks nice. I used some clear packing tape to put my negatives back on, and now I can finish up the bandsaw work. It doesn't look like much of an angel at this point. It needs a lot of work. The first thing that I want to do is remove some of this excess material away so that I can start to sculpt the arms. In order to get her halo nice and round, be sure to use a compass on the top. Don't try to freehand it. It'll turn out like an egg. The remainder of this project is just smoothing it all with a rotary tool. Just by rounding over the edges, you'll make an enormous difference. The secret is to make short taps. If you press too hard, it'll just burn. The vast majority of people who watch my videos only watch about 2.5 minutes of them, so this being buried in such a boring segment will probably not be seen by too many people. This is the blade that I used for the table saw video. You didn't really think I was stupid enough to run my hand across a running blade, did you? I want to take some of this material out of the center here, just to try to give her arms a little bit of definition. I also want to narrow down where her hands come together, just like I did in the prototype. I kind of like that. Now I've switched to a smaller sanding disc so I can pay attention to finer details. Well, there is no limit to how much detail you can put into this, but I'm going to call this good enough. There's one more technique that I want to show you as far as the wings go, but they are by far easier than this part. Some hand sanding got it really nice and smooth. Now I'm going to apply a white stain to it, and hopefully that'll make her look really angelic. After the stain dries, I'm going to apply this water-based sealant. I tried lacquer last time, and I did not like the effect. applied 2 coats of white stain to get it to look this way. I'm pretty pleased with it. I also had to disc sand the bottom just a little bit in order to get her to stand.